If someone landed here from outer space and wanted to know what Norah Jones's music was like, how would you describe it?
I don't know if I could.
Well, you could try. Go ahead, try. Spare?
Sparse, yeah, maybe sparse.
Uncomplicated?
Yeah, it's simple. It's simple music. For simple people. No. it's very simple music. I find beauty and simplicity and subtlety, you know. I find when you're beat over the head with stuff sometimes, it turns me off. That's just me.
You like it to sort of slowly seep into people maybe a little bit more?
I don't know how
yeah,
to describe
cause
it.
Yeah, because every song probably is, yeah, is different.
So. Every song is different. I mean, sometimes I listen to PJ Harvey and I think, God, I just want to rock like her, you know? But I make music that suits the way I sing also, you know. I try not to overreach.
Well, let's talk about that voice because it is so unique and raspy. Have you always had that raspy singing voice?
I wish it was raspier. I've always wanted to sound older. I can't wait till I get older and have a really low voice, you know. I've always wanted to sound like Tom Waits, kind of.
Well, you could smoke a lot of cigarettes and drink a lot of scotch, and that probably would do the trick,
too. I could go that way, but I don't think I could handle that.
Yeah. But your voice has a very unique sound. When you were little and you were singing, did you always have kind of this tonal quality in your voice?
I'm not sure. I always knew I could sing. It came naturally to me since I was little, but I don't think the quality showed up sort of in high school.
How do you create that sound?
It's just softer. When I sing hard and loud, I have less control, I guess. Which is funny because I think some people have less control when they sing softer.
I know what you mean. You must have a very different sound. It's breathier,
yeah,
and a little less clear,
yeah,
in a way.
Mm-hmm. It's not pointy.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I grew up listening to singers who, a lot of jazz singers who had a lot of nuance, which you don't always find in pop music. I do think you find it more in jazz, and that's the kind of stuff I grew up listening to.
And also, it seems to me that phrasing is really important in your music.
You always want to sing the melody and make sure you're not messing with the song just for the sake of messing with it. That's the balance you try to walk.
Like being too American Idol-y?
I don't know.
Well, you know what I mean when they do a lot of vibrato and
moving around.
Mariah-ish and, you know.
Yeah, I mean, that can be great, but there's always that balance. You want to strike a balance of course, I can't do all that stuff because I don't have that kind of voice, but, you know, the way I sing, back phrasing or just messing with the melody. You want to make sure people recognize the song.